Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you for coming this morning. Before we begin, I want to do a few acknowledgments. Commissioner Donna Miller and Commissioner Kevin Morrison will be speaking. Commissioner Anaya and Commissioner Moore have joined us as well. Thank you. Chris Patterson, Assistant Secretary, Illinois Department of Human Services, Office of Firearm Violence Prevention, will be speaking. Israel Rocha, our CEO, and Dr. Farhan Bokhari, who is Chair of Trauma and Burn Surgery at Cook County Health. In addition to the folks who will be at the microphone today, we have representation from Black Men United, Breakthrough, Build, Claritian Associates, Enlace Chicago, which is Little Village, Growing Homes, Institute for Nonviolence Chicago, Lawrence Hall, New Life Center, Proviso Leiden Council for Community Action, Roseland Ceasefire, UCAN Chicago, and community liaisons supporting the Cook County Safety and Justice Challenge from our Cook County Justice Advisory Council. So thank you all. Thank you all for joining us. We are very grateful. Last week I was here at the hospital calling for gun reform. After the tragedies in Buffalo, Uvalde, and Tulsa, our nation saw a dozen more mass shootings over the Memorial Day weekend. We at Cook County have made a significant investment in violence prevention over the last few years, including $65 million in this year alone. However, it's clear that getting trained on how to save a life is just as crucial in our current climate. I'm grateful to the Cook County Health teams for the work they do each and every day and their readiness to provide care under the worst of circumstances. They save lives. I'm also grateful to our partners here today. For many years, we've provided grants to community-based organizations working to make our neighborhoods safer. These organizations support youth and adults in ways that reduce community violence and recidivism. These organizations, too, save lives. We must respond to gun violence from all perspectives, from creating policies to curb the misuse of firearms to addressing systemic inequities that lead to violence. We also need to know how to react when someone has been gravely injured. And that's what we're doing here today. We're here to learn how to stop bleeding from medically trained personnel. These important, tangible skills can help save the life of a gunshot victim. I also hope you'll join us in supporting our organizational partners here today. And I encourage you to learn more about the county's violence prevention initiatives, which are in collaboration with the state and the city of Chicago. To learn more about what we're doing, please visit engagecookcounty.com/violence-prevention. Thank you. And now, I'd like Commissioner Miller and Commissioner Kevin Morrison to come to the podium in that order. And if you would be good enough to introduce the person who comes after you, that would be great. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Madam President. Good morning. I'm Cook County Commissioner Donna Miller, and I represent the 6th District, and it's in suburban Cook County and southwest suburban Cook County. I'd like to thank President Preckwinkle and CEO Mr. Rocha and the trauma team here at the hospital who'll be training us on how to stop the bleed so we can learn how to stop a person from bleeding when an emergency situation arrives and we're in a position to help a victim of gun violence. It's unfortunate that we have to focus on this issue at this time in our life, but we do. And gun violence has been an epidemic in Chicago and Cook County and indeed our entire country. The suburbs are not immune to the crisis. Unfortunately, we're seeing an uptick in violence in the south suburbs as well as across the whole country and in our backyard, especially amongst our youth. And as we are taking this training, it might be something that we are also going to focus on another level once we all become more familiar with it. So everyone who knows me knows I like statistics, so here are some that we could focus on. Americans are 25 times more likely to die from a gun homicide than other people in high-income countries, and more than 100 are killed by violence daily on a daily average, and more than 13,000 gun homicides each year, and 100,000 Americans are shot and injured each year. So far, there have been more than 200 mass shootings, defined as those who were in which more than four people were killed or injured. And since the Robb Elementary School shooting, there have been a multitude of mass shootings. There were 10 mass shootings in the U.S. just over the past weekend. And in 2020, firearm-related injuries became the leading cause of death of children and adolescents between 1 and 19. The CDC recently released updated official mortality data that showed more than 45,000 firearm deaths in the United States in 2020, and it's a new high. As I said in a statement that I released after the Robb Elementary shooting, enough is enough. In 2020, I sponsored a resolution declaring at the county we sponsor June as Gun Violence Awareness Month to draw attention to the crisis, and here we are in June, yet again with a higher focus on gun violence, and it's most certainly a public health crisis, which is why we're here today. I also was proud to join and speak at the Stop the Violence March in Dalton last year, which is in the South Suburbs, because certain areas in the South Suburbs that I represent have seen an increase in violence and crime. It can happen anywhere at any time, in your place of work, in your place of worship, in your school, in the street, at home, shopping for groceries, so you never know where these skills provided at the Stop the Bleed training will be needed. I pray that none of us or you who are watching will have to experience gun violence, but if you are in a position to help save a life, it's important to do so. I appreciate this training, and I'd like to hear from my colleague, Commissioner Morrison.
Thank you, Commissioner Miller, and thank you, Madam President. Hello, everyone. I would say good morning, but I feel like solemn morning is more fitting. I'm Kevin Morrison. I represent the Northwest Suburbs on the Cook County Board of Commissioners. Stop the bleed. Stop the bleed. I feel saddened that we have to be here today, but I feel like courses like this are incredibly important, especially in this time of age. Though we are in a healthcare setting right now, you never know when life-saving techniques, which, you know, I'm grateful for all the instructors at Cook County Health who are going to be leading today's training, will be needed. In a church, in a religious setting, in a school, it is heartbreaking to see all these episodes of violence that continue across our nation and even here in Chicago and in Cook County. It is truly heart-wrenching, and I feel like empathy and compassion are more critical now than ever. We must do whatever we can to see the warning signs that exist within our communities, to show compassion and care to others. Bullying, for example, is linked to many individuals who end up committing acts of gun violence. Stopping just someone in your immediate vicinity from being bullied might have a critical impact down the road. So finding ways that we could all work together and really truly improve our communities, because anyone impacted by gun violence has lasting scars. So I'm grateful that Cook County is investing time to train commissioners, train staff on how to address instances of gun violence and how to use these life-saving techniques that unfortunately we might end up having to deal with in our own lives. And so I appreciate all of our healthcare workers for leading today's training effort. Again, I am saddened that we have to be here today, and I really am grateful to Madam President and our Cook County Board for pushing forward an investment to really move us on a better path forward. So thank you for having me here today. And next up, we're going to have Chris Patterson, Assistant Secretary at the Illinois Department of Human Services.
Good morning, and thank you to the Cook County Commissioners and Madam President for the invitation and partnership, most importantly. A few years ago, I had the privilege for the last few years, maybe the decade, working as a outreach street professional. And I see many of you in the room today. You know, and today I head up the Office of Firearm Violence Prevention, which was created by Governor Pritzker's administration to address firearm violence across the state. We are closely partnered with our city and county partners, and from this office, we'll make an investment of $250 million towards a three-year plan towards reducing firearm violence in the city, county, and state. I think just this more important than the funding of groups that are in the room today and the groups that are across the city, county, and state, and those organizations that have been doing life-saving work of keeping children safer and communities safer, is giving the tools to individuals like the individuals, the heroes who are in the room today, the heroes who are on the street, giving them the cognitive behavior therapy, the mental health support, giving them the tools, again, to make sure that you know, when they're doing the work on the street, the work that they're doing actually translates and saves lives. And so Stop the Bleed is another one of those important tools in that tool belt as you go out there on your day-to-day to make sure that those communities are safe. Hopefully it's a tool you'll never have to use, right? And then that's the important component of it all. Too many times, outreach professionals, street outreach, case managers, victim advocates see the gruesome side of violence as it happens in our community. And, you know, it's just shameful and it's sad that we have to have a training like this, but it's necessary. And we thank you for being on the front line. We thank you for taking up the call to action and making sure that, you know, our communities are safer. So thank you for that. I will not go on and on and on, but I, you know, I feel like I can just talk about, you know, the brave work that is being done on so many levels across so many communities. But as we go into the training, I'm sure we'll pull a lot of great information from it. And again, you know, the idea is once we learn something, it is incumbent upon us to then teach it, right? And so as we get this information, we take back to our organizations, take it back to our communities, so others can be in the same situation we are. Thank you. I'm gonna introduce Israel Rocha, CEO, Cook County Health. Thank you.
Thank you, and good morning to everybody, and thank you for joining us today. I'd like to start by thanking President Preckwinkle for your steadfast commitment to addressing the root causes of violence in our communities and for providing the critical funding needed to effect change that helps our hospital do what we like to do best, which is to be able to help Cook County residents live their healthiest life. We firmly believe that starts by providing you with the tools that you'll learn today, how you can help someone gain those few precious moments to stop the bleed so that they can get to a healthcare professional. It is an essential element you'll be learning, and we ask that you do share it. We do believe the greatest thing we can do is to create an empowered patient experience. And that starts with the education that we're providing today. So thank you for joining us today to learn these skills, and we hope that you will pass them on, because the tools and the skills that you are learning give you those tools that you need to help someone extend their life, to get that needed time to be able to get to an ambulance, to get to a healthcare professional, to get to a hospital. And so it is essential what you will be learning today. I would also like to thank our Cook County Board of Commissioners, including Commissioner Anaya Miller, Morrison, Moore, and Sims, and Cook County Health Board of Directors Story, for their ongoing support of our health system and for working to combat gun violence from all sides and holding us accountable to do so and challenging us to think new ways to be able to provide solutions to this effort that we are all involved in to make our community safer and our country safer. And I know that we won't rest until we achieve it. The road is long, it is challenging, but like many things and all illnesses we face, it's something that we must overcome together. I'd also like to recognize Chris Patterson, Assistant Secretary of the Illinois Department of Human Services, the Office of Firearm Violence and Prevention, for the work that you do and for your colleagues for developing comprehensive approaches to violence prevention. Cook County Health is committed to tackling this endemic issue of gun violence from multiple angles, starting with our clinical care, our research, our outreach, and hands-on learning like today. We will be coming back in the days ahead to bring even more solutions to the table about what we're doing together as a community to be able to address this issue. More than 45,000 people die from gun-related injuries each year in our country. And as you heard the commissioner say, but I think it's worth repeating, gun-related injuries are now the leading cause of death for children. You will hear things that say, should we really be afraid of guns? And you'll hear people who maybe do not understand the true depth of their words. But I think it's important to know that right now in our country, the most impactful thing that is taking children's lives is gun-related activity. And I think that bears a moment of concentration and reckoning of something that we have to do together as a community to change. And while we think that gun-related injuries in terms of crimes, the use of firearms and suicide attempts and accidental firearm discharges increases the possibility that anyone can be impacted by guns, sadly, we must all be prepared to respond to worst-case scenarios. Be prepared to save a life. Today, that is what you're doing. You're learning how to be able to save a life. I'm grateful to Cook County Health Trauma Team for putting on this training and for the work that they do every day. These medical experts come in, sometimes in very difficult situations, to save the lives of Cook County residents. And they are sharing their expertise with people who may one day be first responders themselves. We are here to show how simple actions can help every individual become a hero. And I hope that they inspire other people to learn what they need to do to save a life in the event of an emergency, and that the actions and training here today will lead to change in our community. Quiero también dar unas pocas palabras en español. Cook County Health está comprometido a abordar la pandemia de violencia armada desde múltiples ángulos, que lo son nuestro cuidado clínico, la investigación, los programas de alcance y aprendizaje práctico. Más de 45,000 personas mueren por lesiones relacionadas con las armas de fuego cada hasta este país. Las heridas por armas de fuego son ahora la principal causa de muerte entre los niños. Es importante saber esto. Y aunque pensamos que las heridas relacionadas con las armas de fuego en términos de delitos, el uso de armas de fuego en intentos de suicidio y disparos accidentales de armas de fuego aumenta la posibilidad que cualquier persona puede verse afectada por las armas. Lamentablemente, todos debemos de estar preparados para responder en el peor de los casos. Estar preparado para salvar nuestras vidas. Gracias al equipo de trauma de Cook County Health por organizar este entrenamiento. Todos de los días, estos expertos médicos salvan las vidas de los residentes del condado de Cook. Estamos aquí para mostrar cómo acciones simples pueden ayudar a cada individuo a convertirse a un héroe potencial. Y espero que esto pueda inspirar más personas a aprender lo que deben para salvar la vida en caso de una emergencia.